Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the president of Nea Demokratia, Antonis Samaras.
Je suis heureux de me trouver parmi vous à cette ville phocéenne de la Méditerranée, une ville très riche en histoire et culture, et je remercie l'UNP et les autorités de la ville de leur hospitalité imparable. Dear President and dear colleagues, at 1 o'clock last night, the government budget for 2012 was voted in Greece with an unprecedented parliamentary majority of 258 out of 300 votes. As I'm sure you all know, last month, Mr. Papandreou proposed his referendum idea, which jeopardized the October 26 European Council's decision regarding the sustainability of the Greek debt. Indeed, it created great uncertainty about Greece's commitment to the European integration, and obviously generated political turmoil and social instability. Our party, Nea Demokratia, actively intervened and successfully addressed all imminent dangers. The referendum was scrapped, Mr. Papandreou was removed, and a new interim government was formed under Mr. Lukas Papadimos, former Vice President of the ECB. The task of this interim government is to ratify and implement the October 26 decision, eventually leading to general elections in a couple of months. In a nutshell, the new government aims at restoring Greek credibility abroad and political stability in the country. Nea Demokratia, the true pro-European political party in Greece, played a vital role in forming the new government. We participated in it with the Ministries of Foreign Affairs and Defense, and we strongly support its tasks and its commitments. Dear friends, we are all here firm believers in the social market economy. This distinguishes us from the socialists on the one hand and from the liberals on the other. Socialists believe in extensive state intervention. They believe you can order the economy to grow. This has always been proved wrong. Socialists try to generate growth by overspending the budget. Instead of long-term sustainable growth, they usually generate huge deficits and out-of-control debts. Liberals, on the other hand, believe that markets can do everything by themselves. Supposedly, they can self-regulate, self-grow, self-correct, and self-adjust. Well, it has repeatedly been proven that they cannot. Markets do generate income, wealth, and prosperity, but they also generate asymmetries, imbalances, and distortions. Thus, markets need neat and effective regulation. So we believe in market dynamism, unlike the socialists, but we also believe that markets should obey rules and be subject to regulations, unlike most liberals. What should such rules be? What should we do to move Europe forward? First, fiscal discipline. Societies should not live beyond their means. Second, adjustability. Economies should have the capacity to evolve in a perpetual changing environment. Otherwise, they will perish. Third, flexibility. Economies and societies should have the capacity to absorb shocks and sustain losses without breaking apart. Fourth, liquidity. Modern economies can never survive a credit crunch, can never meet their targets or overcome damages without enough liquidity. Four basic rules, five words: fiscal discipline, adjustability, flexibility, and liquidity. They should all go hand by hand together, never one at the expense of the other. Fiscal discipline is the prerequisite for long-term sustainable growth. All others Adjustability, flexibility, and liquidity are prerequisites for competitiveness, the dynamic potential of growth. In this context, we can draw many lessons from the Greek experience. For the past three decades, Greece grew without fiscal discipline. We had nominal growth at the expense of fiscal stability. We all know now where that led us to. And we will be paying for a long time, as Greeks, the dire consequences. Let me, however, place a personal comment from our very recent experience. When you try to impose fiscal consolidation in a country already in recession, at the expense of everything else, you will most probably miss some of your major targets, and recession will get deeper. As it happened in Greece, where stubbornly high deficits persisted and debt to GDP ratio skyrocketed at non-sustainable levels. But we can no longer afford to be the only European country in five consecutive years of recession. We therefore need to jumpstart the economy in order to achieve primary surpluses right away, as the budget we just voted last night requires. We need to exit recession in order to balance our overall budget as soon as possible and reverse the debt dynamics. We are in full agreement with the targets of the program we have in Greece, the means to achieve it, and the time path. But we desperately need to prioritize recovery. The social market economy is a continuous challenge of balancing priorities between the market and the society, between growth and sustainability, between rights and obligations, between motives and constraints. In Greece, we learned our lesson the hard way. I'm glad I was given the opportunity, Mr. President, to share with some of our friends and colleagues, fellow believers in the social market economy, these ideas with you. Thank you very much.